What is going on, everybody? Dan with Gear Focus here, and today we're going to be talking all about DaVinci Resolve. I switched over to Resolve about a month ago because Premiere was just way too frustrating for me. It kept crashing, and it's also super expensive. It's over $600 a year, and for a program that I can't trust, that just wasn't worth it. So I went ahead and I switched over to Resolve, and there are a couple things that I think that everybody should know when they switch over from Premiere to Resolve. So today I'm going to give you 5 tips on making your switch from Premiere to DaVinci Resolve a little bit easier. So jumping into the program, the first thing I want to talk about is importing your media. For me personally, what I do is I make my file structure in my hard drive what I want it to be when I am doing my editing. So in order to keep that, we do have to import our files a certain way in Resolve. So in order to do that, we're going to go head down over here to the Media tab. And as you can see, we can navigate through our hard drives. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on my external hard drive here. And you can see that I have a couple wedding folders here as well. Now, if I click on this one, you'll see that I have a bunch of different folders and subfolders, and you can see that I have all of my footage here as well. So in order to import those and keep all of the file structure the same, you're gonna go ahead and right click, and you're gonna hit add folder and subfolders to media pool and create bins. Now, sometimes you'll see this little pop-up that says it has a different frame rate. That's fine, just click don't change. And then now you'll see that I have all of my file structures right here. I have my Canon 6D, my Blackmagic 6K, and my EOS R all in their own folders so that when I go over to the edit page, they're all right where I need them to be. Now when it comes to the actual editing part, there is a way to make your keyboard shortcuts the exact same as they were in Premiere. So what we're gonna do for that is we're gonna go head up to where it says DaVinci Resolve right here and click on that. Hit keyboard customization, and then up here in the top right, you'll see it says DaVinci Resolve, but if we click this drop down, we can actually switch everything over to Premiere Pro. And also while you're in this page, it's probably a good idea to set up any custom hotkeys that you had as well in Premiere. That really helps speed up my workflow and make switching over just that much easier. So now we have our media imported and we have our keyboard shortcut set up, the next thing I want to talk about is adjustment layers. I use adjustment layers all the time in Premiere, especially for color grading, and you can do the exact same thing here in Resolve. So if I take my clip and I click and drag it over here onto the timeline, you'll see that it'll show up just like it does over in Premiere. Now, in order for us to get to our adjustment layer, we have to turn on our effects library, which is up here at the top, and then under effects, you'll see adjustment clip. So go ahead, drag that over. And it again is the exact same thing that it does over in Premiere. So we can go ahead and change our color on here and it'll do everything on our timeline. Now you can do a bunch of stuff with adjustment clips such as transitions and things like that, but I won't dive too far into that today. That'll be in some other videos in the future. All right, so this next thing might seem a little bit silly, but it did take me like 3 weeks to find this. And I'm talking about color grading. And in Premiere, on the Lumetri panel, your exposure and your tint and your contrast and your temperature are all right at the top of the Lumetri panel. But in Resolve, they are a little bit hidden, so I just wanted to show you guys how to find that. So underneath of our color tab down here, if we switch over, you'll see down here at the bottom, we have our contrast and our pivot, which is essentially our exposure, as well as our saturation and our hue. Now, if we click on this number 2, that is where our temperature controls and our tint controls are. Now again, this is not a major breakthrough, but this is something that I thought was a little bit hidden and that you guys should know where it was. And now the last thing I want to talk about is keyframes, because they are a little bit different in Resolve than they are from Premiere. So in order to edit your keyframes, you want to go ahead and click on this Inspector tab. And this is essentially your effects tab when you're in Premiere. So if we wanted to, say, zoom in or something like that, or change the position, what we would do is we would click on these little dots, and that would create our first keyframe. Now what you'll notice is on the end of the clip, these little things popped up down here. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna scroll forward a little bit more in the timeline. I'm gonna create another keyframe, and I'm just gonna change my zoom just for shits and giggles. Now, if I wanted to go back and edit those, what I would do is I would click right here on this little keyframe tab, and it would bring up my keyframes in their position where they are on the timeline. And then from here, I can just click and drag those to wherever I want them to be, and it'll move those keyframes in place. Now, one last thing I did want to mention as kind of a bonus tip is with the color grading tab. In that tab, we have the ability to save a power grade, which essentially is just keeping all of your settings and pasting them onto a new clip. So in order to do that, all we have to do is right click on our image and hit grab still. Now what this is gonna do is this is gonna save our power grade to this image. So if I go ahead and I just delete all of these, you'll see that my color grade has reset and I have nothing over here. But if I go back over to the still and I right click on it and I say apply grade, it brings all of my nodes back up in the same order that they were with the same settings. This is really useful if you have your color grade on one clip and you know that you're gonna need to do that for multiple clips. All you gotta do is right click and hit apply grade and you're color graded. All right guys, so that's gonna do it for me today. I just wanted to give you a quick video on switching over from Premiere to DaVinci Resolve. I hope you guys enjoy Resolve as much as I have been. It's really changed the way that I edit and my workflow, and it's really improved what I do. And it's also free, so there's that. All right guys, thank you for sticking around to the end of this video. We really appreciate it. And if you could go ahead down and hit that like button and also hit that subscribe button while you're down there. We're trying to get to 5,000 subscribers before the 1st of November. So if you could help us do that, it would mean a ton to us. All right guys, thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay creative, and I'll see you next time. Peace.